Okay.
All right. Again, thank you to everybody for coming today. So we, at this point, we have an updated master plan that we've been working with Howard Stein Hudson on. It's been scaled back almost to pretty much exactly what it is now, just improved a little bit. I just want to open up the meeting, I guess, with some public input, if anybody has anything that they want to say or ask, any questions, to open up the meeting. No?
I guess I have a question. So this is pretty different than the plan that was presented at the last meeting.
It's really not that different. The only thing that's different is that the playground was in an L shape before, and now it's not. That's it.
Okay. Because. Okay. Well, they've moved the baseball.
That was
fields into the wooded area.
That was because of the request of Steve.
Okay, that's what I'm trying to kind of just so that we have a kind of close the loop on everything, how it kind of got from this to this. So that was from Steve?
Yep. Nick, do you, I don't know if you want to elaborate.
So did you guys work with Katie and to get the
Steve did.
Okay.
That wasn't anything that I've done. But I think it'll look nice having the outfields and the soccer fields all in the middle of the property, that you won't have the backstops breaking it up, kind of how it is now.
Okay.
I think you'll look out on the property and it'll be nothing but green space, which I think will look nice.
Was it Steve's suggestion to also keep the garage and to...
The garage is to be determined at this point.
What does that mean?
I mean, we don't know what we're doing with the garage.
Okay, because I'm here, it says it's going to stay, right?
Yep, that's because...
It's there, right?
Yeah, I mean, we're trying to find a use for the garage, because it would be sad to, you know, we just put some money into it to tear it down. So, for now, it's staying on the plan, but there's... It could very well come off.
Have you guys looked at any costs for repairing it? Because I know the roof was in pretty bad shape.
Yep. We got an estimate from Falcon Roofing, who does a lot of the roofing for the school buildings.
Yeah.
It came in pretty high. They wanted to do a full restoration, including the roof support boards as well, not just reshingling it. But money that we're prepared to spend if we have a use for it. We don't have to use for it.
Can you tell us what that was, approximately?
I think it was $15,000.
And would that be something that, like, the permanent building committee would fund, since it's an already existing building, or?
You'd probably do a capital out of facilities.
So the changes from getting from this plan to this revised plan was pretty much done by Steve and Katie. Right?
Yep.
Sorry.
Yeah, I have some questions. Of course, I'm going to sound like a broken record here. My concerns are with the existing trees.
Yeah, and they actually, we took that into consideration when we met with Howard Stein Hudson.
Okay.
And they moved everything considerably, like, and to give enough space, like you had said, away from those trees. Those trees are not being touched, and there's not going to be anything impeding those trees. They're out as far as regulations.
I noticed the walkway is going almost right over one, right through the critical root zone on another. In fact, two more. So I don't understand. Would you like me to show you on the plan?
Nope, that's okay.
Okay.
You don't need to show me, but again, we completely took your input from the last meeting into consideration.
Okay.
And they went back, and right now they are where they should be. Everything is the distance that it should be away from those trees. And so, I mean, I can go back to Howard Stein Hudson and address that, but we absolutely 100% took that into consideration in the meeting with them.
Okay.
Yeah.
But then this plan is not to scale. Is that what you're saying?
I think what he's saying.
I'm confused, because I look down here, I see a symbol for a tree, and right next to it is a sidewalk. a new sidewalk. How can that be?
Nick, you were in on these meetings, so you want to...
Well, I believe that's not a sidewalk per se. It's going to be a walkway with permeable material.
Okay, and you're still going to go into the root zone.
Yep.
And, you know, then what my statement was, protecting the trees, you know?
Yep. Well, there's also 3 new trees added to the project as well.
Yeah, but I can see probably 2 to 4 trees that are at risk for damage.
Yep. And we will take every precaution to mitigate any damage done to trees.
Yeah, that was taken into consideration.
I've got a question for you. Were you involved with the library?
No.
Okay. Hopefully it would be done better than the library or...
No.
Okay.
I have my own issues with the library.
Okay.
Right now.
Are we going to follow the agenda?
Yeah.
Or because I had some comments on the plan because I got my copy that you sent.
Well,
so you
public input was the first.
Okay, I just want to make sure because I have some comments on the plan, but I don't want to miss out on being able to give them. So.
No, absolutely. That's what we were just going to open it up with public input. So
okay.
If you want to.
No, I only. That's the perfect time.
Is there any extra copies in
this
room? No, it's okay. I guess, Bill, do you want to go over that stuff when we review,
Sure.
We go to the review section?
Yeah. Whatever works for the...
Okay. We've noted that from other meetings, sir. Is it Jim?
Yeah.
Yeah, we've noted that from other meetings, and that was one of the first things we brought up when we sat down with them. So, again, like Nick said, that's fully being taken into consideration. And I gotta be honest with you, if there's one thing that I love up there, it's those trees. So, I mean, again, I think I've said this in other meetings and some faces are familiar and some are not, but the original thought behind this entire thing was to really just beautify Roberts Field, not to make it into an amusement park, a destination, nothing, but to just make it a little bit nicer than it is. Because right now, I mean, let's call it what it is. I mean, it's kind of just a crappy field. I mean, you know, the playground has come to the end of its lifetime. The baseball fields are not maintained. You know, the soccer field is not maintained. It's just kind of there, you know? Like, we bring our kids up there all the time, and there's, like, ledge at the front. It's just not that nice, you know? And so that was really the full idea, I think, behind this whole thing. And I think that it's kind of gotten to a point where it's become, I think, slightly frustrating because the original vision was only to make something a little bit better and more beautiful. That's it, you know? I mean, so I think, you know, this is not my forte, this is not my background. So for me, I think sometimes if I seem like I get defensive, it's only because, you know, I kind of have this beautiful vision in my head of just a beautiful field and just a beautiful playground and a nice place for the kids of Chelmsford to go. And I'm really not trying to, we're really not trying to do anything negative. So that, I just want to put that out there that, again, you know, those trees, that's one of my favorite parts, especially in the fall when they're like, you know, beautiful colors. And in the summer, that's like one of the only shade that's provided, you know, for that area. So please don't think that I'm like dismissing you or becoming defensive or anything like that. That's very important. I agree with you. So if that's an issue, whatever happens with this plan or when it's approved, believe me, that's going to be taken into consideration because that is something that's so important for the vision of the field. It's part of it. It is what it is. So I just want to reassure you that's the goal. So again, just kind of reiterating that to new faces.
Getting back. Oops, I'm sorry.
No.
Go ahead.
I apologize for not being all your meetings, but nonetheless, what by moving the ball field, moving the soccer field, cutting down a third of the woods, how's that going to make the fields look any nicer other than they may be new the day you build them, but 10 years down the road, they'll look like they do now. And they look like they do now because they're not being used. Not because they're cruddy, because they're not being used.
Well, the other thing is that we've been in touch with baseball, soccer, lacrosse. The thing is that no one has really asked anything of them until now. And so we've reached out to them and have said, listen, if you're going to use these fields and if this is going to be part of your system and things like that, then we need a little help from you in return to help to maintain the fields, okay? So, soccer is just an overflow field. So that's why that soccer field was put in the middle, because that's really not used that much. So that was just going to be part of, right now, it's not an open field. There's two baseball fields smack in the middle of it. Yeah. So it's really not an open field. So I think the idea behind this and why, Steve was kind of thinking that this would be a better idea. First of all, it's not really woods there. It's just overgrown brush.
Okay.
And is it a third of it that they're cutting out?
It's substantial. I mean,
I threw out a third. All I did was my knowledge being there and looking at the diagram. And
I guess what you're saying, I'll grant you, the
worst view tree is overgrown brush. That's correct.
Yep.
And that's like that purely because the soccer field's like it is in the ballpark, because it's not being used or maintained. Now, the two ball fields in the middle, they don't look so great. If they don't want to use them, why don't you just remove it?
They do want to use them.
Yeah, I think baseball has come in and said they're not going to use that third field. They're looking for...
Oh, the T-ball.
Yeah, they just wanted to...
But they still want to keep the other two.
Yes.
All right, well, that's fine. Move them down there, but you got to cut into the woods to do it.
Well, again... That was something that Steve, the town engineer, that was something that he kind of brought up. Because again, what he had said was that is a lot of brush back there. And also too, again, to keep that kind of an open field in the middle. And that was his brainchild. No, so.
But some of that brush that's growing will eventually be trees again.
Sure.
But the forest takes a while to grow when it gets cut down. Or beat them.
Yeah.
And there are substantial trees in there that we looked at actually today, that are in this cut line. 100-year-old oaks, 75-year-old pine trees that would be removed if this was a plan moving forward. Primarily for the second field, the one closest to the pond, but it would still be impacted with this. This dramatic of a cut into the forest. But I have some more comments on that that we can cover.
Okay, go ahead.
First of all, there's some substantial, that's not brush in there, there's some substantial and nice trees in there.
Okay.
So, brush is not the issue.
Okay.
Problem with this is there's no maintenance, no fertilizing, no aeration. All the things that have to go into maintaining something so people will use it. They won't use it because it's crappy.
That's not actually true, because it's been discussed about putting an irrigation system in there.
Well, so you need fertilizer, you don't need an irrigation system for that. Aeration doesn't need an irrigation system for that. Liming doesn't need there's a lot of maintenance that's not being done here. I've walked that area, and I taught turf management for almost 20 years. Mm-hmm. I can look down and see more weeds than turf. It hasn't been fertilized. It hasn't been maintained. That's why it's in a crappy area. My point is, you come in, you put a new field in, and you don't do anything more than what's been done in the last one, you're going to have the same thing
in
about
3 years. So is the answer to not do anything at all and just let it...
Let it be just...
And let it be crappy for the next 25 years? Because there's turnover. And so here's the thing. I mean, again, my reasoning behind doing this is to have it maintained moving forward. Like, I have young kids. I have a 4-month-old. I have a 3-year-old and I have a 4-year-old. And I have no place to bring them in Chelmsford that I can just let them run. So if you don't think that for the next 20 years, like, I wouldn't be doing this, because to be honest with you, I mean, like, this is volunteer to me. So if you think that I'm not going, that there's not going to be a plan in place to make sure that moving forward for the next 20 years, I mean, again, yes, there's always turnover. Things get old. Like, look at the schools in Chelmsford. Like, you know, that's the thing. I mean, there will be a plan in place to make sure that this is maintained. Again, we've reached out to baseball. We have the town invested. We have Gary's support. We have Steve's support. You know, so the thing is that, again, so is the solution to this? I mean, I know that you're presenting some opposition here about things. I completely understand what you're saying. But is the answer then to not do anything at all and then just let it deteriorate further? Because that's not the idea.
You're misinterpreting what I'm saying.
Okay.
Exactly. I agree.
Because how about just maintaining what you got now,
rather than putting out of cannot be safe. It's rusty and unsafe. The equipment that is.
Yeah, it's unsafe.
What, the playground?
The playground.
No.
We're not talking about
the playground. We're talking about the big field.
What do you mean at the end of its life? It doesn't wear out.
Of course it does.
No, it doesn't. What's wearing out?
The concrete has been lifted out of the ground. Everything that was sunk into the ground, the concrete, has been lifted over 40 years of frost and thaw.
What concrete?
It's leaning the bases of the fence posts.
The sort.
It's leaning at a ridge. Trust me, it's unsafe. I would not let, if I had kids, I would not let them play there. The existing situation is untenable. So something has to be done. Either raise it all and don't do anything, or build new, but what's there is just not usable anymore. And I don't think it can be repaired cost effectively either.
I think what he's referring to are the cement foundations.
Yeah,
the footings.
It's a foot above level. Above
where?
The
for the backstops.
The backstops. Okay. For the baseball.
Can't they be either reset or just raise the ground?
The benches
around
are leaning every which way. They have sharp edges, rusty wire. It's not something that you would send kids to. I'm there every day. I live here.
I can understand that, but I'm looking at what I see is just pure lack of maintenance. And unless there's a plan to maintain it, it's silly to rip something out, put something new in, and then not maintain it.
Agreed.
Properly. Right now, I think the only thing they do is run a lawnmower over it.
So would establishing maintenance goals or
maintenance plan would be
for similar spaces. Do they get fertilizer treatments and lime treatments? And in other words, does any other lawn in this town
not
get maintained in that?
I have no idea. I couldn't speak to that.
Murphy's soccer field. Go over and take a look at that. Compare the two.
I think that's taken care of by the soccer organization over there.
Right.
But it's taken care.
Well, the difference is, we're talking maintenance or no maintenance. To purely move the two fields, or flip-flop the three fields, that's what you're doing here. Actually, not quite, because you're making a silly and a big space up on the hill by parking. But to just flip-flop the fields, if somebody's not going to use them and maintain them, they're just going to look like that again very shortly.
The thing is that they are going to be used, because we had proposed to get rid of the baseball fields altogether.
And
baseball did not want that. So we told baseball, so we, Mark represents baseball, right?
I speak with
them. Yeah. So.
I don't represent them anymore.
Okay. You don't represent them anymore, but you are very closely involved.
So they're going to come back and use them. Or they just, maybe we might.
No, they're. I think with baseball, again, believe me, it was my thing that I was like, okay, well, if baseball's not going to maintain the fields, this was my original gripe with them. Why do you feel entitled that you should be able to use the fields and not maintain them? So originally I had said, listen, I'm an athlete. I've always been an athlete. I love sports, but I don't think you're entitled to just use town facilities if you're not going to maintain them, or if you're at least not going to help maintain them. So, again, on the original plan, I was like, let's get rid of the baseball fields. They have hundreds of baseball fields in this town, right? So, that was on the original plan. Well, then we went to baseball, and they said absolutely with their enrollment right now, there is no way that they could get rid of those fields. And so, Steve and Nick and myself and Mark have all talked to baseball about the fact that if they want to keep those fields there, they need to be involved. So that's part of the plan with baseball. Because, listen, we were ready to wipe those fields out altogether.
I mean,
because right now, it doesn't look like they're used, right? Because they're awful.
They're not used. Well, no, that's not true.
Used.
A half a dozen teams
in
the spring do use them.
They are used.
Right,
yes. Because his son plays in
the
middle of
the
park.
Yeah. Right.
To
say they're not used is ridiculous. They're only used for a short period. That's the problem.
Have another issue, and that is the ledge where you're planning to put your soccer field.
Yeah, I was going to mention that too. I mean, does this include the... how are we going to get that field level?
Well, first of all, the ledge is more towards the front.
Mm-hmm, to the front.
Okay, right. But the town has enough fill that Steve has said that they're going to fill that.
Okay.
We're going to fill it.
So they're going to fill the whole area?
They're going to fill a good part of it. He said this town has enough field to fill that up 2 feet.
Within the wetland buffer.
But then you have to fill in where the baseball fields are going to be to make it all level.
No, are you going to have a hill in between and steps?
That wasn't the
or
plan.
Or a retaining wall or
the
something.
The plan was to fill it.
So you put up retaining walls or something. Then.
I really wish
you're not going to fill all the way to the woods, 20 feet.
So where is he? Because he was supposed
to be here. I'm sorry.
It's cool. 20 feet, they're going to fill all the way to the woods.
So low as well.
But 2 feet.
Huh?
2 feet.
2 feet?
Did you just say fill to a height of 2 feet?
To a height of 2 feet.
Well, in spots.
Yeah.
But is that going to be enough?
Yeah.
That's a pretty good hill up there you can dig into.
2 feet, I think, isn't going to do it. Has anybody gone out there and done some test pits to find out what's under there before?
That's what Howard Stein Hudson is for, and that's what they've been paid $30,000
for. Have they done it?
$39,000?
No, $9,000.
Oh, I thought it was
18.5 is what the selectmen approved.
The final bill came out too. It was around 9.98.
Okay. Well, we got the final what a bargain. What a bargain.
Their bill as of billable hours to this point.
Is
9.8.
Okay.
This is a small piece.
So I guess just in listening to what everyone's saying, one of my issues is that it feels like that we're trying to force too much into the park.
Okay.
It feels like that. I know we're adding two baseball fields. They're two larger fields. They're taking up more space.
Yeah.
Realistically,
I'm done. Pretty much.
There's two fields there.
Yeah, I'm done. This is ridiculous. This town is ridiculous. Thank you guys for being supportive, because this is crazy. It's insane. It is insane. You have done nothing. Nothing but oppose this and just completely try to like foil and be negative, and I don't even care if it's on camera.
What's going on here? We're just bringing in some common sense from people who live next to
exactly common sense, right? To try to improve something in this town, and all you do is get negativity. That's all it is negativity.
You just asked what about the ledge and the hill.
You don't understand. You haven't
been
here for
the
last 2 years.
Hill in this
it's ridiculous. You're ridiculous.
That's what it is.
So the whole idea of having this meeting was we were hoping to have a plan approved tonight so we could go to the selectmen. Because if we wanted to put something together for Springtown meeting, we're getting to the time, you know. If we wanted to put any money together for Springtown meeting, you know, it has to be put in January.
Mm-hmm.
Not seeing it. And then, you know, if we don't get to Springtown meeting.
I don't think we're anywhere.
Are there any budgets? Has anybody come up with a budget for how much is it going to cost to put a ball field in?
I apologize for not coming to all your meetings. I was the first one. And one of the things that was loud and clear in the first one is you can have all the plans in the world, but if you don't put some dollars beside it, of what is this improvement going to be, what's this change going to be, what's the maintenance and backup and preservation is going to be. And if you don't attach a budget to the changes you want to make and starting out with, we don't have a dollar at all to start with. They got to go together.
Yeah, the whole idea is the playground's coming out within a year. You know, the
playground, I don't think anybody argues about it needs a new playground.
Yeah, I mean, and this, this was trying to, you know, if you're putting the money in for a playground, the whole idea was, oh, you keep the playground, the existing playground in place while you build the new playground. If you do that, you need to shift around things.
Okay.
Things got shifted around, and that's kind of where we're at now.
And don't you approve the plan even before you have the budget? In other words, I thought that you get the
this. This could be a pie in the sky plan. We could have
exactly, because the fundraising, whether it's independent in town or whether it's grants from this or that, seemingly the idea would be to have the plan and then work towards it from a fundraising standpoint, right?
Yep. And we were looking for a combination of grants, town funds, and private fundraising.
Right. Which could take, who knows, could take 1 year, could take, God forbid,
10 years.
5 years, whatever the case may be.
But the playground's coming out within a year, and we were just trying to get this.
Right.
So to put in a new playground, all you gotta do is move one ball field, take down the backstop, and you got the ground for the new playground.
When you take down the backstop, it triggers all sorts of code compliances. The old backstops aren't code compliant. You need dugout protection, you need... This isn't my area of expertise.
Oh, no, I understand that. When you make one change, you gotta then update the code for everything on the property, if you will.
It's within the realm of reason to think that you're going to have to do the other backstop as well.
Sure.
And, you know,
then phase one might be when you put in a new play, take the two backstops down. If that's it.
Yeah, I mean, but baseball doesn't want to be without a field. For what period of time? You know, when does phase two start?
Did they give us information? I mean, have they put that information in writing?
I mean, I talked to Mike Donahue, who's heavily involved with baseball, and they said, you know, if they have to go through the pain of, you know, one season to get a better field, you know, they will figure it out. They will play on softball fields if they need to.
Right.
But, I mean, you can correct me if I'm wrong.
No, I think there's got to be some kind of contingency after that fact. You can't ask the organization to totally shut down, cut down two ball fields, and try and have them survive.
I don't think putting up one or two new ball fields is a big project.
Yeah, and I think they were excited
about
it. A little
bit of fence, a few poles.
Especially if it was going to
regrade the land, water the grass, and you got the ball field.
Yep.
But I don't know whether I still don't understand the philosophy of take so much of the woods away. You already got an existing, I think, full-size soccer field. You got two existing ball fields already. Can't you just flip-flop them then without moving?
These ball fields are bigger than the ones that they're replacing, per the request of baseball.
So those two that are in place now, not the T-ball field, but those two that are in place now are smaller fields. So they fit in that profile better.
They're too small.
So these two are bigger.
Well, if you take out the T-ball, they'll spread out more, won't they?
They don't really want to go near where the T-ball is because it's so wet over there.
But they're right on top of it with this second field.
So yeah, but they don't want it over here.
It's the back end of it.
Yeah.
But it's still going to be the same. I mean, it's submerged.
When it rains, that whole soccer field stands in water.
Well, especially this corner.
I walk the dog down there every day, and I mean on a wet day or when the frost comes out, that's boggy because there's a ledge right underneath of it, and water don't go nowhere.
Can I inject one thing about your plan on the second field? My property is this property right here, a pond. I'm back there with my grandchildren for years. Right? The area, the second field is virtually swamp. It's barely maybe 6 or 8 inches above the pond. So if you're going to have a baseball field, you're going to have to do something to bring a lot of fill in to bring that up. I hope that's in the plan at this point. at least be aware of it.
I really wish the town engineer could have made it tonight, but I believe that was in the plan.
The other thing to consider too is that if you're standing, if you're looking at this, the second field here, if you're standing on this, where the hiking trail is back here in the back, and you look out, it's the grade, I mean, you're, it's a hill. So it's, there's like a 15 to 20, or I don't
know. No, no, 15. No, and I think it's ledge.
That drop hill. Down, so, this far end of the, of this is in, it's in that, right? So, I mean, that's, you know, that's going to be difficult, I think, to blast that out, which we'll have to do.
I think you'd likely hammer that versus blasting in a residential area like that.
And that's all forested. And so, I mean, that's, to me, that looks like, I mean, I think this plan could, I think this area could support one large baseball field close to where this one is now. But I don't think that it can, I don't think the area can support a second field because of the drainage and because of the topography of that area that you're saying you want to cut out. But that's just my speculation. I'm not, you know what I mean? So I think that part of this whole planning process would be, would be useful if we could have an accurate topography map done and have an accurate survey. Because, you know, I look at this and I look at the topography and I don't think that it's, I don't think it's as accurate as it needs to be. I know the hiking trails, but as are listed on here, aren't accurate. So I think from a value standpoint, from a taxpayer standpoint, you know, if we're spending $18,000 for this drawing, I think it should be accurate. And I think it should be something that we could use with further down the line, you know, for map kiosks or whatever. So I think that this information should be as accurate and correct as possible. Also, I think that it would be benefit to inventory the trees here. I was, like I was saying before, when we walked, I walked it today, and there's at least one very old oak tree growth in here, sort of behind the second one, the second field. And there's a couple of other older, I'd say probably 50 to 75 year old pine trees that are mixed in here as well. So I go back to the comments from the public input surveys, and you know, one of the things that people really wanted was shade. So to me, you know, getting rid of these trees that will take another 100 years to grow that are providing shade now.
I mean, you're talking about shade in the woods, though.
Not if it was incorporated into the plan.
Oh, you're talking about like weaving the trail, this through the
could woods. Potentially be one idea.
Yeah.
Nick, is it a foregone conclusion that the playground is going to be removed? In other words, is that
The playground is past the point of dumping money into repairing it.
Gotcha.
This whole idea was, you know, we're a year-ish out from target removal date.
Yes.
I don't know if we're going to have anything in place by the time of target removal date.
Right.
What do you have for funds?
Right now, we have, it's around $9,000. We have some money available from CPC that I think we're, you know, relatively well positioned to get. And we had talked about whether putting in a warrant article for town meeting or soliciting above the CPC donation, or not the donation, the request level, which requires a town meeting vote.
Yeah.
So that's kind of what we're gearing for towards April.
I think we need, I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. No, I guess all I was trying to figure out is so let's say we don't submit anything. Let's say we are unsuccessful in determining plan forward. Are we going to end up in a situation with no plan and no playground?
Potentially.
Mm-hmm. Right. So that, from my perspective, I kind of look at it sort of two ways. In other words, if it's one 100-year-old tree or a new playground, and we could incorporate, obviously, multiple new trees of some reasonable maturity in healthy, strategic locations. I mean, I live right around the corner on Galloway. I would be very inclined to have new trees put in a park. That's seemingly part of any normal renovation to a space of this type, I would think. I can't speak to ledge and fill and all that kind of stuff, but...
Could I address that?
Yeah.
Here's a picture.
Sure.
This is the field, right?
Sure, yeah.
Okay, here are the little trees that they want to take out. And some more over here. This, see this little thing right here?
Sure, the shack, the skate shack.
No, no. See that little line? That's a new tree. That's what you get. That for that.
Yeah. To your point, Greg, I don't hear that it's an either or. My concerns are strictly on just this one particular field, and the bocce court. I think that area could be used differently. And we can talk about it if you want.
If it's proper or not. Here's the aerial photograph.
And my issue is mainly with that, and with the positioning of the
and here this
soccer field. I think every shot on goal.
That's what you get.
Mm-hmm. What's that?
That's been in the
soccer field up next to the parking lot.
Good, sure. My
not concern with that. Soccer, they still got an open field to play.
It's nice that it's open, but you know, every shot on goal is gonna end up in the pond.
Every fly ball to right field is gonna end up in the pond.
If the second thing is done, sure. But maybe one of the things. I feel like maybe we need, as a committee, we need to address what should be included in the plan. Like, what are we tasked with delivering?
Yeah, yeah.
Because I think there's the belief that maybe this is the plan, but in my thinking, this is like, especially if we're going to go to
takes a long time to grow a tree. You can't afford to buy a full size.
We should have one.
Jim, can you guys pardon me? Participate in the meeting, please.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, just the side conversations.
Oh,
if you guys.
Okay. I'm sorry. I apologize.
I guess I was under the impression that we had already gone past that. In other words, we have a plan. We've done multiple sessions of it. Public input, SurveyMonkey. We spent $10,000 on this.
I know, but we have, like, the committee hasn't even given, as far as I know, hasn't given their thoughts on the plan. Like, if I hadn't gotten this plan from Evan, this would be the first time that I would be seeing this. Right? I did get this from Evan the other day, so I was able to look it over and talk about it. But going back to my original question is, I don't know what the deliverables are. I've seen other committees, like for Varney and for some of the other things, and the things that they've put together, and they have a much more comprehensive plan than just the drawing. And I go back and I look at what the Mill Road Committee, I know it's a different property and everything, but what they presented at the town meeting, and I mean, they got over 2 hours of questions about their plan, and it was for a similar amount of money that we've spent on this. And they were being asked questions that I don't think that we've even considered yet. So I definitely wouldn't feel comfortable going in front of town meetings trying to present this. And I question what, but that's not. I haven't worked on any of the committees, so I don't know how that works.
I mean, in my eyes, the going to town meeting was mostly for money for the playground. Kind of was, but that's been kind of my whole push the entire time.
Right. And we really don't, do we have any concepts for what the playground would actually look like?
I mean, it's not difficult to bed it out. You say, I'm working with a 95 by a...
So why don't you just go over and do that? And we can leave the ball fields just as they are, and we can leave everything just to the average.
Well, I understand what you're saying. Once they start...
No, I'm saying why don't we just...
Well, because we spent $18,000 on this plan. And I mean, from a taxpayer standpoint, we need to give the taxpayers some sort of value.
I think the big thing is we need a playground.
Yeah.
Right, Nick?
Yeah, I mean,
so
the whole idea...
So going fun, just do the playground.
The whole idea with this was...
You can do another committee. We got guys that want... Other stuff, that's fine. We need a playground there.
Yeah, the whole idea was to...
And then we don't have to have baseball fields. They can stay right where they are. We don't have to touch any of the third of the brush What if you touch anything? What? And we could just do the playground. For the can we go in front and just do the playground?
But you use the playground for the time of the construction.
What's that?
You would
lose use of the playground while it's being redone.
So sure, lose it, yes.
Yeah, the idea was to build a new one next to it and have the old one available for that year.
Well, can I suggest one thing?
Sure.
The land to the left of, if you're in the playground.
Yep.
In the playground facing the road.
The houses on Thomas Drive.
Yep.
There's an area that's all overgrown. It's got some kind of weed growing, and it grows 2 feet a day sometimes. Mm-hmm. Yep. But is that land available? Is that still part of the plan?
I believe we had heard from a neighbor on that side before.
Yeah.
And they said they were okay with the current noise level, but they didn't want us encroaching much further.
Well, we're going the other way, right?
Well, initially. But I think he was suggesting...
Just put it right where the playground
right where it is now.
Is.
And what I'm suggesting is that you need to have some way to keep the weeds... Because the weeds tend to grow right over the fences and everything.
That's ideally, you'd want to have something you could easily run a lawnmower all the way around.
So,
if you got ahead of it, I think a lawnmower would be
you tear down one baseball field and leave the other one while you build a new playground.
Yeah.
You can't do that because somebody in the permit department is going to say you can't leave one.
Well, then you have baseball come and figure out where they can put another baseball field. They can do that.
Right. Have this committee just
in the meantime, you can raise the fence behind the T-ball field and they can practice little league right there.
Why couldn't they use a soccer field? Because that's not used.
That'll keep the ball from rolling in the woods.
They can still have a game on the soccer field.
Yeah. Yeah. So can we do that?
I have no idea.
I'll just say that I'm not comfortable with that. I mean, we went to the Board of Selectmen and said we were going to come back with a master plan for the park. They gave us this money to spend for a master plan, and I feel like we're not meeting our
did a bunch of private fundraising for this purpose to the tune of many thousands of dollars.
I don't know what it is. I just know that the Board of Selectmen voted to give us $18,500.
Right, none of which... I don't know, you guys have to correct me, I don't know exactly, but of the 9,800, I have no idea what percentage of that would have been from selling lemonades and, you know, tickets and raffle items, and, I mean, we've had multiple private fundraisers now. In other words, I don't feel any obligation in terms of, I mean, I pay taxes too, I wouldn't feel any obligation to any other taxpayer in the room based on the amount of private fundraising we've already done.
I disagree with that, but...
Because you didn't come to the fundraisers.
I did, I came to the fundraisers. And from what I heard, they broke even. But I don't know if that's true or not. So.
I think they were fairly successful.
Who'd you hear that one?
Why
don't we just go to... If we can't just... I'm just... suggesting doing the playground because there seems to be a lot of issue with everything else.
Right.
Which is fine.
Yes.
We can have, you know, I just know from Nick that we need a new playground. And that's a big part of why we were looking to do this. And if that's something we can go forward with, at least as a phase one maybe, and I don't know if that's possible, and we can revisit everything else afterwards. I mean, at least get the playground done because it's something that the town needs.
You can't even see to
it. Is that...
Yeah, right. I mean, that's a reasonable assumption. I'm not sure if it's doable. I mean, I can certainly look into it, and that seems like a good compromise as well. But I can't speak to whether that can be done or not.
So what do these guys have to do? What do Howard Stein Hudson have to do? Are they on hook for any additional deliverables?
I mean, we have not used the full amount of funds yet, so we can go back to them for revisions.
And what sort of, I guess hypothetically, if we had a perfectly topographical plan and a plan for maintenance, line, fertilizer, whatever. I guess I'm trying to figure out, would that satisfy the impasse? If this was topographical,
the
and the engineer said...
It just doesn't carve up into so many parts. You cannot move and enlarge the playground and move and enlarge the two ball fields and still fit it all in. I think that's just unrealistic. To me, this looks like the space is not there. You have to cut down trees, you have to fill, you have to contend with the ledge, you have to move the fields, you know, too close to the pond to be useful. I think this is a pipe dream, the way it's on this plan. The playground moves in and becomes larger. That triggers moving the ball fields. Now baseball says they want two fields and they have to be bigger than before. I think that's everybody trying to get a bigger slice.
Well,
from
I think
the cake,
that,
but there's
that,
only
I'm just speaking like I don't think for personally, if there's zero ball fields or one ball field, I'm fine with it. But you got baseball that wants two fields. I mean, they've been the ones that have had those fields. I'm on board. We won't look for open space. That's what we've been.
We'll then pay for it.
Can I
yeah.
Finish?
How bad? When they reach in their wallet, that's when you usually find out if people want something or not.
I think they found this as a time to push it forward.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean.
So do we go forward and say, all right, let's do one ball field so things fit? I don't think anyone's here going. I mean, baseball then wants to push back and say two, then they should be here saying, this is what we're going to do.
And it should be in writing, and we should have a...
You know, you and I know, you know, she got upset with things. So she's just frustrated. Just wants... her idea with this couple of years was just to make it nice, because it looks like crap. Right? It looks like crap. And that was her vision.
Ours
and that's why... That's why she's frustrated.
Maintenance.
But you know where the field was? If you want to go back 30 years, the soccer field wasn't there. There was still a bigger hill there and more.
Yeah. So her vision wasn't, to have two baseball fields back there. It was open space. It was to have trees. That was the vision. But yeah, baseball has fields, and they pushed us on us. Like, they're going to have these fields. So Steve goes and gets two fields on it. You know, and you know, so our hands are a little tied. Okay, that's what we're going to do. Like, again,
I don't think they are, though. I think as a committee, we can.
But again, I don't know. Nick, you answer that. I mean,
I was told that my impression was that, you know, they are a pre-existing stakeholder on the property, and they have a right to use the space as well.
Absolutely. So that they get one bigger field, and we don't have to chop up the forest, clear cut the forest. To,
again, I'm going to argue both sides. I think they're going to look back and say that we have 2.5 fields.
Right.
We're going to go to 2 and bigger. Okay, and that's where, yep.
My thought is you still have the issue with the ledge and the soccer field.
Yep. Well, again, I can't speak with Steve.
It's a package deal.
I can't
speak. And until somebody goes in and digs and finds out and does the grades, you know, yeah, the projects are tied together, the ball field and the soccer field. You can't do one without the other. You can't do
again,
the project.
To me, I would just say, go forward with the
playground.
With the playground. Get that done.
Take the fresh ball field out, put in the new playground,
I mean,
and then start over. Yeah. That seems simple to me.
Yeah.
The playground is important.
I mean, it solves the discord now, but I go back again to we have an opportunity to create a master plan for Roberts Field, and it may be uncomfortable to discuss, but we should be discussing it and what makes sense. I mean, this is the conversations that we should be having.
Yes, but there's never any resolution to it.
Because
we
don't have a plan.
No, that's not true. Because baseball has their input and soccer has their input. We're coming together and presenting the best that we can, but it's not good enough for some people who are concerned about the trees. So let's just step back. I agree with Charlie. We want a playground for the kids. That was the goal. Yes, would it be great to beautify that entire area and start from scratch? Yes. But we don't have the funds for that. We don't have the ability for people to agree on where things are going to be. So instead of the kids not having a playground, we fundraised for the playground. Let's put the playground in.
My point is only that we've already spent the money for this, and I think that it's a lost opportunity if we don't come out of this process with Howard Stein Hudson with some sort of a plan. I mean, if we were able to find a configuration that everybody was happy and unhappy with, that we could all live with, you know, the DPW could build the walkways. There could be, like the picnic pavilion could be an Eagle Scout project. I mean, there's things that we could build that wouldn't necessarily cost or require a lot of fundraising, but that we could implement and would make Robertsfield a lot nicer, right? Would fit that vision that Shana has and that I think we all have for it. But if we walk away from this and say, no, we're just gonna go with the playground and forget this, I feel like we've lost an opportunity. But that's my take. And I personally...
Yes, but we've been going around and around on this for how long now?
We haven't met in 8 months. You know, we haven't lived in one round and round. We've had.
Okay, prior to the 8 months, how many times have we met and discussed and changed and had public input?
Discussed this? We've had 3 meetings that we've actually discussed a plan or had public input session. The other meetings have been pretty much about fundraising and stuff like that. We really haven't. And then hiring Howard Stein Hudson. We really haven't talked about what features we want to include, what makes sense for the park. We just haven't had those discussions. We haven't. And we've got the, you know, you can go to the website and look at the videos and you can see the discussions that have happened so far.
So where do we go from here?
I'm not sure. Also, it might be a good time to mention to everyone that their seats expire the 31st. So if you're interested in re-enrolling the committee, you gotta go down to the clerk's office and let them know.
Is the expectation, and I mean this in all seriousness, but mm-hmm. when it comes to a space like this with, an outdoor space, obviously, with water and grass and trees and, a living space, so to speak, in terms of a master plan that essentially takes a lot of the same features, baseball fields, playgrounds, etc., and shuffles them around, is the expectation that there wouldn't be any trees and such disturbed that couldn't be reasonably replaced with legitimate, properly placed and planted specimens? I mean, I'm trying to envision how any master plan for any outdoor space of any type...
No, there's always a trade-off.
Right.
That's reasonable.
Right? I'm totally with you.
But
so that, I guess, what I would hate to have happen, which in my mind has happened a number of times now, is that we spent, $10,000 of whoever's money, either fundraising money or taxpayer money or whatever the case may be, and seemingly these are the types of questions that cause challenges. I'm trying to figure out if I'm going to stay on the committee in the hopes of, retrofitting the field for my kids, I would like to not come back and do this again in 3 months and have things like trees stand in the way of a potentially, neighborhood changing master plan for the next 30 years.
Well,
I don't need to be.
I'd just like to say that I understand what you're saying. But I hear you saying we want a polished playground in the environment. Let the kids go take a walk in the woods and see what nature has to offer besides just got to pound it out on a baseball diamond. There's a compromise of the two features.
Yep.
And this map looks like it's, well, we need a little more room, so we'll bulldoze more of nature away and have a little more of man's creations. And you still got to maintain man's creations. Nature takes care of itself. And if you're not happy with the field now because it's not maintained, why is it going to be maintained better tomorrow?
Right. So maintenance.
That's all we ask.
So maintenance is a big one. And I'll concede, maintenance is not something that I recall anyway, that has been part of the plan.
Yep. There's 11 guys who work full time for the schools, all the school grounds,
right.
Parks. They're spread pretty thin.
Right. No, and that's the part, I have no idea how that works.
Well, yeah. Facilities responded to the stakeholder survey, and they said that they couldn't take on any additional features without additional budget. So I would think that part of the plan would be, okay, if we presented, let's just say this is what we blessed, right? This is what we said that made sense.
Right.
We could say that these two fields are gonna require XYZ in maintenance, and it's gonna be done by baseball, who's agreed to these conditions, we'll mow it or we'll fertilize it, blah, blah, whatever it is.
Yeah.
And the approximate cost of that is gonna be this. Right, or the new playground or the bocce ball court's gonna be maintained by facilities, right, and that's gonna require another person to be there. And I just think those things need to be included in the plan, along with the costs.
And wouldn't maintenance be part of the budget moving forward? In other words, let's say, hypothetically, we stamp this baby today, which admittedly is probably not gonna happen, but let's say we did, right? Wouldn't maintenance be a line item on the follow-on budget, and as would ledge testing and test drilling, and that would all be part of the plan. In other words, if we stamped this today and figured out in the spring when we did a fundraiser down at the senior center and raised enough to dig a test pit, and we figured out, it's not going to work. In other words, isn't that stuff going to be part of the line item process moving forward? So when we got to that point, when we said, all right, we're going to reel Shana back in and she's going to send a letter to whatever state grant or whatever, part of the request is going to be maintenance, X number of dollars, fill from the town, X number of dollars.
No,
in other words, that should be the impasse today.
Well, how many pages of text currently exist in justification for this map?
How many pages of text? We have 2 years worth of meetings. We have multiple public input sessions.
I'm talking that if you want to talk about this as a concept and you want to go to a formal. It's my idea that I thought something like that would come in like a bound volume, and you got, well, why is it here? Well, here's a page of explanation. Why is this over here? Here's this. And can that be moved? Because
I see what you mean. And I'm not, as far as the formatting, I don't know. I'm not certain how things are typically presented.
I haven't seen those discussions. I mean, I hear that those discussions have happened outside of the meeting, but I haven't been a part of them, so I don't know. I don't know what they are.
I mean, it can also be reactive. With Varney, they went forward, did their master plan, and they've done phase one, and guess what? It's a very popular site to use. So they actually went forward and hired a person for the site to take care of that site. It was a 3-hour-a-day person who worked part-time for 7 days a week, cleaning the bathrooms, doing the trash there. I mean, maybe that's something similar.
And that was part of the budget that they
Where does that funding come from?
It was reactive. The town said, oh geez, this site that we've created is drawing enough attention that we need to hire someone.
Yeah.
What did their plan look like? I haven't seen Barney's master plan. Was it more than just this?
With Watermark, that plan was put together before I started working for the town. I can recall the pretty picture they put together. Yeah. I'm not quite sure if there was
Did their playground go over,
Didn't touch the playground. It's 80. So phase one is what they've done, was to move a basketball court, ADA upgrades to the beach, ADA upgrades to the bathrooms, and they redid the second floor of the snack shack area.
To your earlier point, Greg, I don't see this as being an issue where a tree, a 100-year-old oak, is going to stop the development of things.
Right, right.
But what I do see it as is, you know, fitting in the features where they make the most sense. Because at some point, somebody made the decision to put that T-ball field in the corner, and that was a bad decision because they spent too much money because they could never use it because it's constantly underwater.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? So I would not want to make that same mistake. And I think, honestly, putting this here as an example is making that same mistake and more, because you're cutting out a lot of ledge, hill, forests, and other stuff. It may be an uncomfortable thing, an uncomfortable conversation to have with baseball to say that we can only fit one larger baseball field in here, but it's unless given another option, I don't know what that would be. And I think we could make this a nice field, because that would be the goal, to have this as a marquee baseball field, you know, that they'd be proud of and want to keep up and want to maintain and want to use.
I can't imagine, and I don't know Howard Stein Hudson from any other consulting group or, you know, architectural firm, whatever they call themselves, but I can't imagine that they would propose this.
If it was impossible?
If it doesn't work.
I'll speak for them, I don't know for sure. I believe they use the topographic and survey maps that are available online. The problem is those aren't necessarily accurate, right? And that's, I call them into question because they need to be. It needs to be an accurate, there needs to be an accurate survey. There needs to be an accurate topographic map to be able to put these things into place. And we can get the surveys done. We had the opportunity to get the survey done last winter through the town, and they chose not to. So
they mean the town?
Yes.
They chose not to do the survey?
We had a volunteer that works for the town that was going to do the survey, and then they decided that it was better not to use his time for that at the time, which, you know, I understand.
So nobody from Howard Stein Hudson walked the cars?
I believe they did.
Okay.
I've got a question. What did you contract with Howard Stein to do?
We have the whole.
It's all online. There's a list. The contract. Everything is posted on the homepage.
What the contract going to do?
Yes, the contract included. It's robertsfield.org.
Okay. I'd start there and see what we spent this money. What were we contracting for? Maybe they have all the soil tests and whatever. How about sharing them?
Yeah.
And another thing, if baseball wants to this or soccer wants that, where are they?
I mean, soccer didn't respond to the stakeholder survey. Baseball didn't respond to the stakeholder survey. Lacrosse did. Lacrosse has been active in coming to the meetings and did respond and wants to be a part of the maintenance. And I'm sure baseball would too, and it may just be an issue of pressing them a little bit more. But I think as a committee, we can do that. And I think that, you know, we can get them to create and sign a memorandum of understanding so that everything's clearly delineated, what their roles and responsibilities are going to be, what the town's roles and responsibilities are going to be.
So, I don't know if the agenda still fits right now. And I don't know where we stand scheduling the next meeting either. Because if we can't approve anything within the next couple weeks, I think we're losing our window for the next couple months.
Schedule a meeting next month? I'm sorry. Oh.
I don't know where we're standing for scheduling a meeting. We're coming to our deadline of getting a warrant article for Springtown meeting. I'm more than happy to meet and discuss, but if we can't put anything together in time to get, we can't put a placeholder in. I prefer not to do that. I don't know if we have anything pressing at that point.
Can't put a place. What is a placeholder?
A placeholder to a roughly worded warrant article to hold a place, because you have to post it so many days in advance.
Well, what's the worst that can happen?
We could get in front of town meeting and they could shellac us. I am.
So, I mean, what are our options here?
I'm not sure.
Okay.
I'm not sure.
So would we just, I mean, and I get it, like, hey, everyone's not quite on board or doesn't like configurations or where things are going to go, but, you know, we have a master plan or whatever.
Unapproved master
plan. Right. We have something that's been put in front of us. I mean, if we go ahead and, you know, want to approve this, can there then be changes? Or is that, because I think...
Oh, yeah, you're not casting it in stone when you approve it.
So, again, this is, you know, just a question in terms of if it gets approved, can we go back to baseball? Or is that, are we past that point? Or,
I mean, minor changes...
What I'm hearing is that we don't want to miss this window. If we miss this window, which is fine. If we miss the window, we have to wait.
Yep.
Or the playground doesn't get done, or whatever the case may be. But if we, you know, go forward with what they have right now, can we still, you know, make some changes to it? Or is that this is set in stone because we approved it? Do you know, I mean,
I'm unsure how my area of expertise there.
You got to be able to make a change. What if we approved it tonight?
I'm not saying
and figure out that we couldn't do.
You can't move a shrub, you can't twist a field, but to start deleting fields and saying,
yeah, you can't do that.
Whoops, sorry about that.
Can you shrink it?
I mean, I think it's set to a specific size that they're looking for. But that's
I don't think this is exactly what they had seen before. So, if I were a town committee, I wouldn't want, or a town youth organization, I don't think I would want a complete change for them. So I would think we would have to run it by them first.
Yeah.
And I do think they'd be willing to adjust depending on the needs, but I don't want to speak for them. I'd rather them actually see it and agree. You know, it's so that they can make plans as they approach their spring season if they decide to do something.
So
how much time will it take to build a new playground? Start to finish.
Are you talking, I have all the money in hand?
Well, I'm saying you can't pay for it. You're not going to build it, are you? I don't know. But no, what I'm saying is can they build a playground in 30 days, in 90 days, in 2 years?
You probably could do it in... I mean, we were looking at like a 2-month-ish window.
Close the old playground for 2 months and build the new one.
In the middle of the summer? You do it
you do it in the spring or fall.
Yeah. We were trying just to make the lowest impact we could there.
But that drives everything else.
Yep.
If that's driving everything else, then use all your options, that's all.
Yep.
And if Howard Stein Hudson was here, is there anything that they could say that would have prompted approval tonight?
I think that's, you're speculating there.
I guess that's the hard part.
Yep.
In other words, I don't know, I struggle to think about what we could have done to facilitate approval tonight.
Can I inject something? Have you guys ever thought of just having a survey done on the survey, this plan of the land? And put some sticks up there or flags up there or whatever you need to do to find out where you're putting this? Because this is really some rough areas back there. There's a lot of ledge in this back corner here.
I got a figure.
And you're talking about putting a baseball field, but are you planning to do blasting, take out some of the stuff?
I'm under the impression that that's the whole point of hiring somebody like this, to do exactly that.
That's the starting point of any project.
Wasn't a survey done. That wouldn't have gone there.
No, there wasn't one done. The town declined to do one, so.
You need to have...
But wouldn't these guys do a survey?
It wasn't part of the...
How could they have dimensions and scale and
because it used what's online.
And you can do a lot of miracles with the computer today and just hit a couple town sites for plot planes.
Well,
but just real quick. Yeah. So like it's like the wetland delineation map, right? So they've got those things posted online. You can get to the GIS mapping. But if you actually have a wetland scientist go in and flag the areas that are truly wetlands, right, it looks very different than what it looks like on the GIS. And that's just the function. They can't do a accurate topographic and wetlands map. It needs to be specific. It needs to be something done specific to the property. You know, I mean, if anybody's interested, I'd be more than happy to meet, and we can do a site walk, and you can look, and you can stand on the hiking trail and see what we're talking about, how this...
The difficult part...
Find out what's there. That's how
the difficult part is we're 10 grand in the hole, and we had no prayer of getting this approved tonight.
Well, but this is the first time that we've seen it. I mean, we haven't, and honestly, the committee hasn't given any feedback on even the other plan that we looked at back in April on this.
And I know Steve's not here, but if you've had conversations with him in terms of, you know, why it's not here, is it because of dimensions of the fields or, you know, where we got to this?
Couldn't speak to that.
I have one other item I just want to get brought in. I was holding signs at the last election day. I ran into Janet, his wife, and we talked about playground things, and I didn't have a really understanding of what they were doing. My daughter plays in Medford. She goes to schools in Medford. And these are some of the...
I don't think we're anywhere near that discussion right now.
No, but you guys are talking about building a playground. I'm just curious what you guys are looking at. So here's some... And I promise I'd bring some pictures of what they look like. And the stuff is great. I mean, this is what they call Spider Park. This is one in Medford, right there at school. And I can see it. It's pretty robust stuff, right? So I'm thinking that's what you see down in Boston Harbor in that area. You see some really heavy duty.
We recently built one like that over at 63 Carlisle Road. I don't know if you're ever over in East Chelmsford, but if you want to take a ride by and take a look at it, it's similar style to that.
And the kids, it's really great stuff. That's, they can climb up and down these things. There's ropes. There's all kinds of different.
I was gonna say that
things.
Actually looks like.
It makes them very interested.
It looks like the one they just built.
Yeah.
I don't know. Again, I'd suggest maybe going over to see it because it actually looks.
Yep.
Yeah.
Identical to that.
And you don't get splinters from any of this stuff, you know, which is good. I'm gonna leave those here if anybody is interested.
Thank you.
So you've already started looking at that. Is that correct?
I mean, we've got a fair idea. We're looking at some playgrounds for the schools as well. You know, the Byam School is starting, you know, to see some wear and tear on their the blue portion, or not the blue portion. They have a playground designed for younger kids. They're talking about moving a playground at the Harrington School because of the pods. So I mean, we're pretty familiar about what's going on, and there's a couple big manufacturers out there.
Yeah. So where is the one you're talking about?
63 Carlisle Road. So if you know where Riverneck Road is?
Yeah.
You go to the top of Riverneck Road,
yeah,
take a right, and you go about, I don't know, an eighth of a mile down on the left right there.
Okay. Yeah, I have to go and look at it. Yeah. But you know, those things they take a lot of abuse, and I think that they usually on the base for the material it's either it's typically wood chips usually.
Yeah, you have to have it depends on the height, but they're looking for 12 inches of what they call engineered wood fiber.
Okay.
That's certified to compress at a certain amount, and you can get
fall
it.
In, right?
Yeah. Unless that means unless you get a toddler portion where you can't have toddlers on wood chips because it's a choking hazard, then you have to have a poured rubber surface. And so I mean, there's lots.
This is generally for older.
Yep.
These are kids in school.
Yeah.
Before we all, I don't know if we're adjourning or what, but I had some comments that I feel like I want to put out there regarding the plan. Some of the stuff we've covered, some of the stuff we haven't. And I don't know if anybody else has any other comments, but I'm just going to kind of, these are all, there's questions, and I'll just start with, it looks like to me that the bathrooms, before the bathrooms were located inside where the garage is, and now it looks like that they're at their own small little area, and I was looking for details about that. If those were portable units, what the size was, if there was going to be power and water there, if there's more than one, it looks like there's two.
I think it was
eight. That's more questions. If they're going to be open year-round, and who's going to maintain those?
I think they're portable, but slightly more permanent than a porta potty.
Okay.
It was more of a... They're movable, to best my understanding, but they're not porta potties. They're a bit more substantial.
So if there's
and there would be a pad port for them so they'd be level.
And so if there's like an issue with cleanliness or something, like if somebody really makes a mess in there, then they would just take the unit out and replace it with a new one. There wouldn't need to be a person from the town or facilities that would have to
clean. I'm unsure, but I know that they are not permanent.
Okay. Would there be an opportunity to include some sort of a, if those are two portable units, would there be an opportunity to include some sort of a covered area so that if like a parent wanted to change in like a seat and a trash bin, so if a parent wanted to change a diaper or sit down and wait for a child to finish in the portable unit, they could do that? So does this, I guess I'm just wondering what this structure looks like. Is it just two side-by-side porta potties, or is it a covered thing that might allow some?
I mean, I would lean towards they're more toward of a porta potty than a building, but it's just kind of throwing a designated spot for the porta potties on the plan.
So there's no... Okay.
Yeah, and it's easy access from the parking lot for the truck to pump them out, you know.
All right, so if we're looking for, I don't want to have real specific about this, but if we're looking for comments on that, I think it would be useful to have some sort of a covered sort of lean-to sort of sitting area for...
And I mean, I've said this before, anything's possible, it's just money.
Right there.
Yep. Okay. I mean, we could have a double-decker baseball field if we want. Anything's possible, it's just money.
Well, I'm still operating on the assumption that we're going to have put together a plan that's going to have the detail in it so that if we do present something to town meeting or somebody else, that if somebody says, well, what's this thing going to look like, we'll have a... either a drawing or a description of this is what it includes, two units and a cover and a seat and a trash bin or whatever, not just a guess, you know what I mean?
But I was hoping Steve would be here tonight.
Okay. And then, you're around. I feel like we need to, I think we need to do a survey. I think we need to survey not only the property itself, but the wetlands, and as well mark the substantial the trees that we want to make sure are maintained, if there are those.
Would you go back to the town for funding for the survey?
Like I said, we had a volunteer that was willing to do it, so at no charge. So I'd be more than willing to go back to him and see and set it up and do it either in off hours or do it during his time.
And who was that?
Scott Ludwig. And then for the wetlands demarcation, I think I could probably get someone to do that as well. So, the next thing was the baseball fields. I've said this, you guys know. I think that this second field is trying to put a square peg in a round hole. It cuts into the forest too much, and it's too close to the pond and wetland buffer, in my opinion. But in my opinion, we need a survey to say it is or isn't. I think if we moved it to just one larger field, one nicer larger field, I think that would be a benefit. We've got, baseball has other fields close by in proximity. They have Strawberry Field, they have McCarthy. There's areas in McCarthy in the back for adding other fields. So I don't think we're necessarily hurting them. I think they still have the opportunity to put another field somewhere else if they want to add to somewhere. I think we need to create a memorandum of understanding with CYBL and anybody else that has a stake in this and that defines what their roles and responsibilities and all that's going to be. The soccer field, I would personally like to see the soccer field oriented so that the end zone doesn't abut the pond that way. It's actually going to, if you have goals there, it's going to put two barriers. So one of my goals was for the master plan was to be able to look across both ways to sort of unite the two sides of the park, because right now it's sort of two halves. And I think with the goals set up this way, it's more of a block between the playground and the thing. Plus, I think any shots on goal are going to end up either in the wetland buffer or directly into the pond.
Yeah, I think they were kind of indicating that using rollout nets.
It's still going to be a visual barrier.
Yeah,
I think that makes an
occasional visual barrier.
Well, they'll stay in place. I mean, there's five goals there now. You know, and one of them has a net, and all the other ones are.
Well, yeah. I mean, the new ones are substantially lighter and easier to move. It's kind of what we were looking into.
And they stay there. So I think that if it was turned this way, you wouldn't have that that visual barrier. My other big comment was. You know, I think the idea of having a bocce court is kind of a cool thing, but I don't know, you know, based on the public input survey, only 9% of the people said that they would like to see it. And I have a concern about, I know it seems like a low maintenance thing, but it actually does require raking and dressing to be used properly with the sand. And my other issue is that because it's so close to the playground, I think the courts themselves, because they're sand, may actually end up becoming kind of a sand pit for the kids. You know what I mean? So one of my thoughts was that, you know, if instead of the bocce court, if we converted, if this was still moved and we had that area open, you could turn that area into a natural playground. Have it, you know, fenced off so that it's safe for kids to play in, but it would be more of like a, you know, a hill for kids to roll down, or loop-de-loops or something, or some sort of a open natural area with a sandy area and maybe a wood mulch area where kids could just kind of romp and run around and kind of be free. And I think you could incorporate into that some of the more nature focus that we've developed on Pollinator Park side and all the hiking trails. For instance, we've just gotten approval for, there's going to be an Eagle Scout project that's going to happen in February, where we're going to, Eagle Scout's going to build 18 different bird, bat, and bee houses that are going to be positioned all around in the woods and in Pollinator Park. And we're also going to have three sort of informational learning kiosk stations that are going to describe sort of what's going on in the birdhouses and kind of the birds and the bees and whatever's going on in there. So
I don't hope the birds and the bees are in there.
So we'll have that. So I think we could kind of build off that.
Maybe the minutes reflect that.
Yes. This is not the kind of park.
The birds and the bees and stuff.
But we could do sort of a scavenger hunt kind of a thing where you could encourage kids to walk the trails and find a certain tree, or walk the trails and find a certain birdhouse, or just some way that would sort of tie in the natural aspects that are happening now with this.
Yeah, new stuff. I mean, real quick, just to interject, I have a friend that lives in Somerville, and they have Conway Park down there, and they've got a walking trail that circles the property, kind of similar to portrayed here, and it's a history of the property. You know, it's a former Superfund site that, you know, they've cleaned up into a park. I mean, I was thinking, like, it'd be really neat to do, you know, you start here, it's 1655, through the years in Chelmsford, you know.
Yeah.
That was kind of my vision, you know, and have them demarcate, you know, the Lucifer Match Company was founded. Oh, you're also 1/4 mile into, you know. That was kind of my vision with this.
That's neat. Yeah, I like that. With the with the Roberts being the original owner and the property originally being farmland, and that could be part of it as well.
You could have, you know, 18 something something, you know, the land deeded over the Roberts family. Right. Yeah, sure.
I think you've already got that pre-existing stuff with the natural park. So if you were to go with a natural playground, that might be a
natural playground is a really touch and go verbiage when it comes to insurance.
In 1962, there was a big barn on that property, and it burned down while I was in high school. And right where the fire station is. That was half the town showed up to watch this thing burn. There's that race car.
Yeah.
No cars or anyone in it, so yeah. Let's say it.
So it could be potentially that area could potentially have sort of an obstacle course, kind of a, for you know for toddlers or for older slightly younger kids, and kind of have a scavenger hunt thing. On the pond shore, the mow line for the pond shore needs to be extended. Currently, it's too close into the wetland buffer, and I think if we had a wetland map. We'd be able to better define where the trails should run in terms of that. So that kind of goes back to having the surveys done. Mm-hmm. I think we need to have the Conservation Commission review and comment on this for that reason, and especially if we're going to move forward with talking about cutting into the forest that way and in that corner. On this plan, the existing skate shack doesn't include the garden that's there now, so that needs to be...
That's a very minor...
A lot of these are, sure. I had sort of envisioned, like I said before, that right now the park is sort of a park of two halves, and I think there'd be a benefit to having sort of a connector through the middle somehow, and I know that's probably not possible with the way that the field's configured now, but... To have sort of a pathway between the playground and the pond, I think would be a nice attribute.
I think difficult, but willing to look into it.
We talked about surveying the hiking trails. Just as an FYI, I can stand on this northern corner of the pond on the hiking trail and look at the property marker for that's listed for on the map, and so it's not overlapping, or if it is overlapping, we need to fix it. So I think that's another reason why we need to do a survey, because right now it shows that the hiking trails or the walking trails abut or are actually on Wolfgang's property.
No, it's not. That's just the trail is just wrong on this map.
And it needs to be. I think it needs to be correct. So that's another reason why I think the survey needs to be done. I think on the plan also we need to note where trash cans are going to go and. Again, make a note that the facilities is going to be the one responsible for picking up the trash. On the original bricks and wooden arch, I think we should add some sort of a map ES or some sort of an informational board that tells the story of what the park is, what's going on, and has the map and sort of has whatever that story is, plus has an area for people to leave flyers and such.
Small details. We're looking for like the view of the forest, not the tree.
Yeah.
You know I mean?
At this point right now, not worrying about where trash cans.
Yeah, I've been waiting for a while to give comments on the plan, so I just want to get through these and then have one. And my only other thing was and you guys talked about this, I think we should part of the plan should be creating what the maintenance plan for mowing is going to be, and there should be an annual mowing of the perimeter, and we should look at or could look at overseeding those areas with flowering native pollinating plants to tie into what we're doing over in Pollinator Park as well. And my only other things were I feel like as a committee we should do, I think we need to define what the deliverables are if we're going to move forward with this. With this master plan. I think we should schedule not only a site walk for the committee to do, but also a site walk for the public to do with us once we've voted on and accept as a plan. And then I think we need to have another public input session, which is what we told the public we would do before we approved the plan. We said we would have a public input session and get their feedback and then approve the plan. And then after those things are done, I think then we can talk about presenting the BOS or moving forward on funding.
Well, I don't know if I don't know if that concludes review of the master plan.
I think it does.
And I don't know if there's any interest in scheduling another meeting. That was the last item on the agenda. I mean, are we talking after the winter? Are we talking something short term? Are we talking, because you're not going to want to survey it in January, and you're not going to want to have a public input session out there in February. So I don't know what the committee interest is. I mean, we can say to be announced, and we can try and put together a meeting.
We should at least inquire about the survey. We can inquire about a survey at any point. I want to build a shed. I could inquire about a survey of my own.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
I can survey in the letter.
Yeah, that's not a...
Well, that's why you have somebody that can survey.
Right. Lovely. Right?
I just need the town to say, I just need Gary to say that, yeah, we can do that.
Well, you want him to survey on the DPW time, which I think Gary might be hesitant to give up his... one surveyor, he has.
Okay, I mean, it's just a matter of priorities. So.
Yeah, I mean, they're doing a lot of work right now with the modular classrooms for the schools.
So will you ask Gary if he will approve Scott to perform a survey for the...
if you put it in an email, I think that'd be the easiest. Like, from the committee, I think is the appropriate way to go instead of me asking as a favor.
Thank you. I can't speak on behalf.
I don't know if you'd like to put a motion forward to vote on it.
I think a survey is based on what pretty much everybody has described.
Yeah.
There's one concern or another about some survey-related item. A path on a property line, or a portion of wooded area, or a distance from wetland buffer. I mean, I had thought that that's what this was. But if it's insufficient in some way, seemingly we should at least get something that everybody can look at the same thing and believe it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I would like to motion to request a survey from powers that be. I don't know necessarily these gentlemen, but Gary and Scott Ludwig.
The town engineer.
Town engineer, okay.
Engineering department.
Okay, town engineering department. Anyone second that motion?
I'll second it. Should we include the wetlands demarcation as well?
Might as well.
So.
Well, that would be, excuse me, but
no.
Wetlands requires digging holes. Don't want to do that in the wintertime. Why not just get your survey and then have your friend go in and do that in the spring?
I can take an ask. Do you want me to ask about just to see what her timeline would be for doing wetlands demarcation?
Sure.
Yeah, I think that's good. And it gets written down.
I don't know if we ever took a vote on to whether to ask for the survey. We just had it seconded.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. Seconded, and shall we vote on it? All in favor of requesting a survey from the town engineering department?
Sure. I'm not sure I can vote.
Yeah, you can.
Pretty soon none of us can.
Seconded by Bill. All approved. Okay.
And I'll send it? Is that what you're asking? Is that asking
me
to send it?
That would be great, Bill, if you don't mind. I don't. I don't have the same connection in this case. And the wetlands demarcation is written. In other words, it's not.
Sure.
They're going to go put flags in the ground, and then they're going to be blown away in the snow in another week. It's going to be written, right?
I'm not an expert at this, but I believe that they do the core samples, and then they pound a wooden stake into the ground as to where the marking line is. They use core samples, and then as well, you can look at the types of plants that are growing. So to Jim's point, I don't know if that's something that can be done now or has to wait until the spring, but I can inquire, I can ask.
And does it change? Does it change over time?
No.
In other words, wouldn't they have had to do that for the last thing that was done, like the shack or whatever?
I think the
policies have changed. Is it on file, I guess is my question, no?
I think the policies have changed. I think since, I think in 95 when this was done, I think the policies were different than they are now.
Probably right. So what happens for a survey or wetlands demarcation?
Sure. I'll inquire about both by email. Okay. And should I copy the entire committee or should I just copy Nick?
I think the entire committee.
You can include the group. Wetlands demarcation to be included in request. Committee to be CC.
Greg, when you get a chance, if I could get a copy of the minutes.
Absolutely.
So I
send them tonight.
Perfect.
You get it.
Are those being posted? Because I haven't been able to find them.
That's exactly what I was inquiring about there.
I get them.
Were you going to someone check with the person that made this plan to see if they have any documentation? Reference to what you're thinking of doing here.
Yeah. We're getting a little bit out of the realm of what I'm responsible for, but I can inquire to the town engineer about if he's satisfied if the deliverables were delivered.
Okay. Well, but somebody must have got a written report someplace, didn't they?
Yep. I have no idea. Not my job.
Okay. No. I understand.
I think the last. And I'm speculating, but I think that the last threshold was to for them to present this at a public input session, and then I think that was the last trigger for it being completed. That's what my understanding was.
Them meaning Howard's?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes. But here again, that thing is listed online. Their proposal and what was agreed to is at robertsfield.org on the homepage.
I kind of read through that somehow, but I guess I forgot something.
There's a lot of links in that. It's kind of a timeline of stuff that has been discussed or approved or whatnot. And it's one of the links in there.
And do we want to say next meeting to be announced?
Yes. Pending this.
Next meeting TBA, pending timing of
survey.
Timing of survey and wetlands.
And just a not to go back on the playground, but I know that's part of your job.
Mm-hmm. I was to push that portion along. And we can see if we can build it in kinds. I mean, we're kind of shooting for first of our fiscal year, which is, you know, around July 1, which is a heavy time for playground use. So, I don't know if that shifts our timelines.
Is closing it down, is that a hard deadline, or is that something that can be pushed?
I mean, you're getting to the point where I'm uncomfortable keeping it open.
But that doesn't mean that I hear you, but that doesn't mean necessarily that it has to be closed.
I'm trying to give you the most political answer I can. It will be closed in the near future.
Okay. Because of imminent danger to participants.
Yeah, I mean, it's getting to the point of, you know, the wood is worn, chains are worn, it's a 19-year-old playground designed to last 20 years.
Well, they fixed the chains. They were actually worn through.
Oh yeah, the swing, it's amazing what little kids can do, just running back and forth.
Damn it, buddy.
I mean, they were worn out.
Yeah.
I complained about it 18 months ago.
Yeah.
And there was like one swing left, and it was paper thin, the chain was so worn.
Yeah.
So what's going to determine if we do meet again?
I think.
Amazing.
And who's going to be responsible for scheduling it?
don't know. I think we're going to have to see what the makeup of the group is come January 1.
Yeah. So we have to
re-up.
Re-up by the 31st.
Well, you have some leeway in January, but...
Yeah.
The town clerk.
Yep.
You do the survey. You guys actually going to lay out where these things are proposed to be? Is this thing solid enough that you want to do that?
I think that's a better question for the town engineer to answer. I can.
Will we get altitude and all that information? How much fill you're going to need to level these things when you put them in?
I think that's a likely thing to request.
Yeah, I think you need to. If you're going to go with this plan. You need that information to pay the cost of it.
Mm-hmm.
Right. But the cover, the only thing to remember is the cost doesn't matter.
Huh?
Because it's all going to depend on public, private, fundraising. The cost could be $100 million, and we have to either figure it out or scrap it. In other words, for our purposes, right, it doesn't really matter if it's $50,000 or $52,000, or if there's 8 inches of fill required, or 12 inches of fill required over here. It's inconsequential, right?
For
our purposes,
no,
right?
But we need to know. But I think we need that number, though.
I believe the town engineer has one, and then you sit down and say, well, you know, if we contracted it out, you need this much fill. Can we swap out for fill that we have? You know, what can we do in a house? I know he was talking today about, you know, just the little parking lot improvements and restriping. You'd probably do that in-house versus hiring it out.
But there's still, even though that's done by the town, there's still going to be a cost assistance.
Yeah,
right?
So. Yeah, but it's not a line item for this field in particular. It's more of the general capital.
But I think we still need to say it's going to cost X amount. I mean, I think that's going to be the question.
We have the number. I assume Steve isn't here, and I just briefly talked to him today. You have the number, and then you chip away at what you can do. You know?
Right.
Yeah.
$100.
Yeah.
Right.
That's what he was saying.
Yeah, in other words, I don't want to belabor it. My whole thing is, I hate to get stuck on things 5 years from now when...
Oh, yeah. If they said the walkway was going to cost $800,000,
right.
Delete.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. I agree.
Yeah.
Or at least set the expectation. She knows it's going to cost $800,000, so that's the important mark to me, is that we know what the cost are.
Yeah.
Construction cost and maintenance cost.
And I was hoping Steve was here because I believe he does have that information.
Should we ask him for that?
Yeah.
I don't know who Steve is.
Town engineer.
See, so his official title is Assistant DPW Director. He was the town engineer.
Or maybe the next time there's a meeting, he'll be here. And
I think we have to time that around youth hockey, because that's why he said he was unable to make it.
Totally understand.
Yeah. So would you refer to it as construction costs? What would you call it?
Construction costs. Accurate way to describe it.
And are we looking for the features, the construction and maintenance costs for the features? These features?
Was that a proposed to the committee or?
Anybody, I don't know.
Well, we should get whatever he's got. I'm not certain what dollar figures he has. Whatever he has, we need, seemingly. If dollars are important.
Would you like me to send an email to him as well?
That'd be good.
I think we have hit all our agenda items. Is there a motion to adjourn?
Yes, I make a motion to adjourn.
Seconded?
Second.
Sounds good.
All in favor?
Right.
Excellent.